Good morning, student. Today we continue the last topic of our chapter number 9, financial management. That is about fixed working and working capital. Fixed capital and working capital. Fixed capital is known as one-time investment because the decision done in fixed capital is irreversible. And working capital are those capital or those revenue that we needed from day-to-day operations so that our expenses must be met smoothly. The meaning of fixed capital is the capital which is used for the purchase of fixed assets is called fixed capital. For example, machinery and purchase of land and building. There are some factors that affecting the requirement of fixed capital. The first is nature of business. The scale on which we are working. We are working for a middle level or we are working in a large scale. Next is choice of technique. If we are working in a technology, that means we are working with computers, so we are working with the technology, then we have to be upgraded it periodically because it has some fixation period. Have you seen that when you purchase a mobile phone and after 5 to 6 months a new one is launched in the market? So if we are working with the technology, we have to take the proper upgradation and we need a proper fixed asset. So there is a need of high or huge fixed capital. The next is growth perspective. If we need that to be growth in our business, then we have to be invested in our fixed capital more in comparison with the working capital. Diversification means then we are working more than one field. That is called diversification in the company and organization or manufacturing unit which are diversified in their production, and they have to be need a huge working huge fixed capital. Financing alternatives, if we have no more financial alternative, then we have to be complete. For example, if there is a no higher purchase or no other machinery that can be easily available on rent basis, or government is not giving us land on lease, then we have to be purchase our own land and buildings, then we have to be need a huge amount of fixed capital. Level of collaboration when we are using the assets of the other companies. For example, in a banking system, you need that they reduce their need of huge fixed capital by using the ATM of other banks. You can, if you are a customer of a Bank of Baroda, you can easily withdraw money from Axis Bank or ICICI Bank. This is called level of collaboration when the organization come jointly and help each other. This reduces the need of huge fixed capital. You know that the current example of the United Bank of India, he is working in Saharanpur, but there is not a single ATM of that particular bank. So in this way, they reduces their huge fixed capital requirement and they can easily contribute to their customer, their ATM card, a debit card. The next is working capital. First of all, the meaning. The meaning is about the difference between the current assets and current liabilities is called working capital. Working capital ko calculate karne ka ye hai current assets minus current liabilities. The rest of the amount is known as working capital, and working capital needed for to meet day-to-day expenses, and these assets are expected to get converted into cash or cash equivalent within the period of 1 year. That's why they are called current assets. Cash in hand, cash in bank, bill receivable, debtors, finished goods, inventory, work in progress, raw material and prepaid expenses, etc. Current liabilities are those which we have to be paid within a year, that is bills payable, creditor, outstanding expenses, and advances, whatever we get in advance. Now come to the other main topic, that is net working capital. What is net working capital? You have studied in your accountancy also these terms. Net working capital is a difference between current assets and current liabilities. See, working capital and net working capital will remain the same, current assets minus current liabilities. Gross working capital, the sum of all current assets is known as gross working capital. There are some factors that affecting the nature of or need of working capital. The same 2 points are same, nature of business and the scale. The next is business cycle. Seasonal factor is also affecting. For example, if we are working with sugar industry, they have to be maintained the raw material for first to two period cycles, and since because they are for and production cycle is also affected. Credit allowed, how much credit allowed to you, and credit avail, how much time of credit you given to your customers also. The next is operating efficiency, how much efficiency is there is also an availability of raw material. If there is a regular availability of raw material, then there is a need of less. Otherwise, if there is a some gap between the raw getting the raw material, then you have to be invest in more, then you need a huge working capital. So in this way, today we have completed revision of chapter number 9. We discuss about chapter number 10 in next video. Till bye bye.